Cassandra is certainly odd. I wonder if I can truly trust her.
Enough. I was beginning to think all this talk of gods and nightmares might have scared you off.
I said I would come. So, great artifact hunter, did you track it down as easily as you said you would?
Not quite. But after studying this island, I found our next step. I'll lead you to it, if you're ready.
On to this next step. This shared expedition is starting to feel tedious.
Spoken as if finding an ancient artifact long hidden away was supposed to be simple.
I take it you've been hunting these artifacts for a long time now.
Yes, quite some time.
What led you to this?
Strangely enough, a vacation gone horribly wrong. Now it has become a destiny, of sorts.
What exactly are we going to do with this artifact once we find it?
I will take it far away from this island for safekeeping. To a place where no one can maliciously wield its power.
Power? So it's a weapon of some kind?
In the wrong hands, it is. The kind of weapon that should never be used.
A weapon that shouldn't be used. That sounds like a sentiment spoken by someone too weak to wield its power.
It might sound strange to you, but trust me, its power is not to be taken lightly. The survival of your world depends on that. This is it. Somehow, this stone formation will bring us closer to the artifact. I think it's a riddle of some kind.
Well, of course it is.
Since you're clearly an expert at playing with rocks, get to solving it then. That's it?
Of course you don't see it.
It looks like the Isle of Skye, but there are several markings on it.
Could it? No, it couldn't be. A map?
I didn't feel the need to state the obvious.
So, what are the markings?
There are several triangles, and one X, not too far from here.
What are we waiting for? X marks the spot. So, do you just spend your days attacking strange women in graveyards, or do you have other duties?
I take care of my people. We have a settlement, Ravensthorpe.
That must be nice. I've traveled alone for what feels like a lifetime now.
You speak as if... How old are you exactly?
Older than you'd think. But everyone tells me I have a young face. That's a very pretty bird flying above you.
Her name is Sunin.
I had a bird once. A long time ago. An eagle named Icaros.
I prefer ravens. Eagles are too...
Godly?
Gaudy.
You're quiet. Not thinking of throwing another axe at my head, are you?
No. I'm just not compelled to feel silence like you are.
Good. That fight took a lot out of me. Not sure I'm ready for a second.
You kept me on my toes as well.
Was that a compliment?
Nothing here.
Stand right here.
Why?
Can't you trust me? Or at least pretend to, so this goes faster?
Fine. How did you know?
Lots of practice. Another ambush! They must be drawn to the temple.
They're very persistent.
Ah!
I've seen this before. We'll need shards, keys, to place on this pedestal. That should open.
No. We need to talk. Those people that attacked us, were they speaking your language?
I already told you. The artifact has made them go mad.
Cassandra?
Eivor, when are you going to see that I'm here to help?
No, you're lying. I'm sure of it.
Have I been anything but helpful to you since I got here?
In the first ambush, those men seemed to know you. And now they're speaking your language? You can't take me for such a fool.
There's a chance that my arrival on the Isle of Skye might be what activated the artifact's powers. But it's not certain. And even if it's true, that's all the more reason for me to remove it.
No. That's all the more reason for you to leave, so I can remove it myself. You've done enough. I can't trust you, Cassandra.
You have no idea what you'd be dealing with. You need my help.
I know what I must do from here. And if those men are after you, it'll be even easier for me to continue by myself.
Eivor, please! The powers of this artifact are unlike anything you've seen.
Nothing is too powerful for me. Besides, I'm sure I'll make better use of this weapon than you.
Ugh, fine. I've had enough of you anyway. You're impossible. You're too brash, Eivor. And it will undo you.
Still need to find all the shards before I can open the door. Better get going. Find all the shards and place them on this pedestal if I want to open that door. Survey the area.
charts I need to place on the pedestal. See you soon.
Oh, yes. Could you please be a deer and wade into the fairy pool so I can sacrifice you to the fairies?
You're asking if you can kill me?
Since the nightmares started, the fairies have whispered in my ear, promising power if I find sacrifices for them. They've even led me to one of their treasures from my hard work, the prettiest shard. So please, into the pool now.
If you want me to go swimming, you're going to have to make me.
That's no trouble at all, dear. I'll help you right in.
us under control.
Under control? It looks like you were about to get skewered.
I can defend myself. You didn't need to come.
Admit it. You missed me.
Let me rephrase that. You shouldn't have come.
I know my death makes it complicated.
These people are attacking me because of you.
I know, I know. Can we talk about it once they're dead?
Activating the artifact. Sorry. And I know me being here makes reaching the artifact. Harder.
Harder? No one would be trying to kill me if you weren't here right now.
I know. Trust me. You will need my help once we reach the artifact. These people are nothing compared to its power.
I'm not getting rid of you, am I?
Don't worry. I'll grow on you.
I've seen mechanisms like this before. I'll get the light working. You direct the beams to those plates near the door.
So, I can move these, I see.
One down, one to go. There, it's opening.
Finally. Those parts and weapons are so strange.
They're from my land.
What are they doing here?
It's an illusion caused by the artifact.
And you being near it. That mask looks unique.
I've torn many of those masks from the faces of cultists. Even knowing their illusions, to see all these things from my
home?
I don't have a home. Not anymore.
trouble for this. You keep it.
Admit it. We make a good team.
You're not so bad to work with, after all. Terrible at following orders, though.
Give me a little credit. It's my first time working with another person in... I don't know how many years.
That must get lonely.
It does, from time to time. But it's the path I'm meant to walk. Anyway, I should get going. It's not good for me to stay in one place long. Thank you for your help. Truly.
Wait. The Norse celebrate their victories. And since in the end you did help, why not come out for a drink with me?
I don't know about that. It's not really good for me to be seen by too many people.
If everyone drinks enough, no one will ever know you were here.
All right. What can it hurt?
Hopefully you're head tomorrow morning if we have a great time. Meet you at the Longhouse in Kiltaraklum.
See you there. There you are. Ready for that drink?
Let's head inside. What is it?
There are a lot of people. I haven't been to a party in some time. I guess I'm nervous.
You just saved an island from descending into total madness. You can handle one drink.
I guess you're right. Let's go inside.
Ah.
ready for a drink. What about you? Ah.
I've always wanted to try meat. Not if it's from Marcos's vineyard. It's like a good paint from a vase.
Marcos? Who's Marcos?
An old friend that made truly terrible wine.
Melka, you really are drunk. Now you're just spouting nonsense.
No, it's a Greek swear word. It's malaka.
Malaka. Malaka. Malaka.
Malaka. That's it. You got it.
Now, me teach
you. The bride and the groom are here.
Are we crashing a wedding?
It was arrogant to assume these people were here to celebrate us, saving their asses. Come, let's join in their revelry.
Oh, aren't you the heroes who saved the island and our wedding?
I did a little more than she did. But yes.
We would love it if you both gave a toast at our wedding.
We hardly know you. What would we say?
But your exploits have made our wedding a day to remember. Please regale us with your tale.
I could be up for that. What about you, Eivor?
All right. But if we're going to do this together, Cassandra, let's make it interesting.
What do you suggest?
A flighting competition, of course.
Ah, never tried it myself. I should warn you, though. I've battled wits with great philosophers.
Stop boasting and prove yourself.
My day began the strangest way. An axe thrown at my head, tending to slay. There stood Eivor, hot-headed and brash.
You wish you had the skill to swing first.
Not too quick on his feet, is he?
It took an ambush or two, and one dusty old temple, for Eivor to see that I could be helpful. But somehow I've melted his cold Norse heart.
And despite her transgressions, I'll give her a fresh start.
I really thought this would be better.
Eivor did the heavy lifting, left the tracking job to I. In the end, we triumphed, chasing the nightmares far from Skye. And to the bride and groom on this historic day.
Your love survived this. Nothing stands in your way.
That was certainly something.
Maybe you two should stick to saving the day and leave the storytelling to the Scots.
It's been a while since I've been the center of attention.
How did it feel?
Strangely familiar. I'm glad you invited me here.
It was nothing.
No, really. Thank you. I needed this. More than I knew. What do you say we make that bride stay and get rid of that asshole?
Don't you mean that, Malacca?
Indeed.
My wedding.
We actually saved it twice.
All in a day's work. Eat it. You come for the wedding?
I couldn't miss it. My cousin is the bride. And of course, I should thank you. Clearly, you were able to help my people. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here celebrating.
I can't take all the credit. I had some help.
True. Valka put you on this path after all. Was she right, by the way? Did you part ways with that girl, Randvi, as she foresaw?
No. Randvi was never on the Isle of Skye.
Ah, well, even Valkar makes mistakes. Still, it's good you didn't need to say goodbye to a friend. I'm
What an unforgettable night.